popping by. It's really nice to have you here. I've got a couple of things that I'd like to show you. How you like all the paper bits, and we do like nostalgia, don't we? We do. Are you warm enough? Yes, the temperature has dropped a little bit. It is still nice to see the sun coming out still for this time. Can I get you a blanket or a cushion? There's one right next to you, but I have another one if you'd like. You're okay. Good. If you are feeling a little bit cold, on a little bit. I'll fetch you a little throw to go over your knees. Okay. Would you like a tea? Or perhaps a coffee? Okay, lovely. I'll go and make that for you and I'll be right back. In that seat. Good. It's one of my favourite chairs, that one. It's nice and deep, isn't it? Yes. I'll just pop your tea on the side here. Can you reach that okay? Lovely. It really is so nice to see you. You're looking well. Are you feeling well? Right. I see. I'm so pleased you're here. Would you like to see the bits that I've put to one side? I left them here because I thought you might enjoy to see them. Yes. Yes, definitely. I am still writing. Still in the process of editing the book at the moment. Perhaps you wouldn't mind if I read out a paragraph to you. Yeah, I decided to change the intro. No problem, I'll go and find it in a moment. Went to a lovely little craft fair the other day, and there was a wonderful selection of homemade items, and this item just caught my eye. I know how much you enjoy the pencils and pens, stationery and paper, and notebooks, like I do. And I thought of you. Delicate floral display. Strange. And the space for a selection of pencils and pens, or possibly maybe some stickers. Selection of stickers for the journaling and scrapbooking. But I just love this very sweet nostalgic illustration. Glad you like it. And then just when I was leaving the craft fair, there was a stall with some old books. And this little sweet one caught my eye. Wild flowers of the chalk. Reminded me of the Edwardian lady books that I shared with you recently. It is a picture of Stonehenge in Wiltshire, but it's a sweet little book. Some wonderful, charming illustrations at the back. With predominantly text for the first. first several pages talking about the subject of cliffs and chalk pits, beach hangers, and the roadsides and hedgerows. Then there's the list of plates, and these are approximately original size. There's a list of them, and here they are, I just found them completely adorable. To perhaps trace and draw. I find it quite relaxing. I used to, as a child, choose a picture and then trace over it and colour it in. That's the chalk milk. Wild thyme. Such pretty colours. The horseshoe fetch. Some of the Latin names are next to them as well. Beautiful yellow petals. And this one's so delicate. So pretty. I'm not completely sure how to pronounce that even. Squinens, I want. Not sure. And then the dropwort. And I do love a blue or purple lavender petal. That's the ramp. Just so sweet. Yeah. Oh, you've got a book similar. Oh, I'd love to see it. Oh, we must. Oh, that'd be lovely. And the rock rose, the yellow. The pasc flower. Gentle pinks. Yellow wart there, and with that sort of warm pink, the pyramidal. This one, maybe because the inner part looks like a bee, is the bee orchid. They just look like watercolour pictures, don't they? Oh, it's so nice to see the pictures of nature. The garden, and as much as we appreciate some of the flowers or plants that we grow, it's nice, isn't it, to see the occasional wildflower surprise us. And then the purple milk fetch. I'm not sure of the age of the book. As you can see, it's a little bit tarnished around the edges. I don't see. It was first published in 1947, but I think this is probably maybe a 70s, something like that, I don't know. But isn't it? Just adorable. Lovely. And recently, I think I shared with you the bits that I picked up for the journaling. A small haul, a selection of things, but there were some gems. But I wanted something to put them in, because I love having the different storage for all the different items. It's, to me, half the joy of journaling or scrapbooking is the little storage wallets or storage boxes. Something just to store the gems. I think it was it the stamps? It was the stamps. The ink pad. Stamps. So I just wanted somewhere to pop those in. Just a couple of little blocks for them to go on. But I liked this design. And as that's got that sort of grey velvet finish, what caught my eye was, of course, the same finish. Velvet finish notebook. With the lovely rose gold finish. I've seen some of your collection of your notepads. Yes. Oh, there is something about a new notepad, isn't there? The way it feels, or the smell. And then to get a new pen to go with it. It is, it's a nice floral design inside, isn't it? Are you warm enough? Yeah. Just pop that. Maybe just pop that across your knees a little bit. Yeah, it's just next to you. Let me just pull it across. There we are. Okay, is that better? I think there's possibly a small draft that just comes in underneath. the doorway there. But yeah, good. I'm glad you're okay. This one has got the ribbon. This for some notes or journaling, scrapbooking, probably some notes possibly to do with some story ideas, something creative, I think. Yeah. Oh yes, I will. I'll go and fetch it. We last spoke. I said I was editing a book, The Sands of Time, and yeah, I've edited it a couple of times now, but I'm just going back over. But the beginning, I just wanted to mix up and change a little. Oh, I'd be happy to share some of the editing with you. I'd welcome your feedback. Yeah. Let me read this to you. Just take a sip of my tea first. There's a corner of the world just waiting for you, waiting to be discovered, a gem, your gem. New acquaintances feeling like old friends, and the sense of it all that you are coming home. When life feels sad or has gone bad, and you seek that glimmer of hope, taking those first steps may be enough to uncover a place in the sun that we never knew existed, a place that offers us hope and reignites that fire in you that had been slowly burning out. Change can be a scary thing, but does it scare you more not doing anything? A few days may be all that you need. What a difference a day could make. What a difference 7 days will make. We don't know when our time will be to discover it, but we all will have our moment. Are you ready to take that first step? Is this your time to rediscover you, to rediscover and ignite your dreams, to rediscover love? Your place, your gem, is waiting for you. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh. Okay, lovely. Right. I will. Thank you for that. Thank you. Super. I think it's the sun's still out in the garden. Fancy just a little wander around the garden. It won't be long now before it does start to get